in the way, isn't it? Have him climb the pole.
Climb the pole. Ask the girls up here.
I gotta remember that place. We're just facing these twists. I didn't say it was gonna be inside a building, Jay. Just walk down this way. It's gonna be at a booth like this. He has a walker, he's gonna be sitting down. You know, see, it's like one of those walkers next to him. It's an older gentleman.
Slow down.
Yes. ask the lady if you can go up where she's standing just for a few moments. You have to ask. According to one of the guys at work, they're having a fair today and tomorrow, up in Slow, and he says it's much bigger than this one.
Yeah. There's the stage. Is there another pavilion down here?
I don't know.
Garlic.
Thank you.
in there, man. No, go back in there, mommy.
I'm looking for the community emergency response team.
They are, do you know where security office is located?
No.
Okay, you're gonna go straight down all the way this way, and then right when you see the carnival rides, you're gonna make a right and go all the way straight down, and then you're gonna go, I don't even know how to do that, but yeah, they're looking for the emergency service, correct?
CERT, CERT.
Community emergency response team.
Yes.
Community emergency response team.
CERT.
Okay.
Convention center.
That's where they're at.
Hey, wait, that's mine. I had to go all the way around and get a new one.
Yeah, no, we would have got you a new one. They're gonna take you.
Oh, is that something? I thought he was just giving it away.
Oh, there's plenty.
Well, the thing is I thought he was just giving it away.
Oh, it's okay.
They don't have a strap.
I
or a hat that has the holes like this gentleman here. You see the hat with the holes on the top? Whenever there's a little breeze, it cools off your head. I have one at home. I didn't wear it today because it was going to be out that long. But they work really great.
Oh, I'm
so you're from Louisiana?
Yeah, you get the hat like
what?
That.
You're from Louisiana?
Yes.
Like a, how do you like it there?
Hat, you know?
Yeah. I like it here box. Better.
Yes. Really? Why?
Because it's not so hot.
Oh, it's
you
hot.
Think this is hot? Louisiana, Africa heat.
No way.
Oh, it's, yeah. There are no outside events planned for this time of year because it's too damn hot. This is not hot, really.
Well, I think I can do this any day.
What?
I can do this any day. After
oh, yeah.
Probably.
Yeah. Yeah, something's burning.
It's the barbecue.
It smells like a motor. About 85 here right now.
Yeah.
The humidity is what, 60%? Add 10 degrees and 25% humidity.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Late August and early September is really miserable. So they planned all the outdoor events for October and November. And March. March, the weather's real nice, but that's it. March and October, that's about it.
Really?
Otherwise, it's either too cold, too wet, or too hot, too humid.
Yeah.
And then there are the constant storms in the wintertime. Yeah, we went in here. Didn't see them.
Looking for the what, I'm sorry?
The community emergency response team. Hams, the hams. There it is.
Found it?
That's it. Thank you.
Awesome. You're welcome.
This is the guy we were looking for.
Awesome. Great. Right. Well, Hi, my name's Tracy. Nice to meet you.
Same here. This is my friend Jay I was telling you about.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Hello. I'm Sean. Pleased
Sean.
To meet you.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, here's your card.
There you go.
Thanks.
I've got one already.
It's okay.
Watch out. People coming by.
Right. Well, I'm fine.
You're fine?
50 megahertz.
Right.
Static, you know, no modulation, just right. Static. And the receiver does all the work.
Right.
Well, that's where it's headed, because they got a satellite program.
Uh-huh.
There's satellites running all the time.
Right.
But there's a ham band on the satellites, too.
Yes.
And I think, and the radar is interesting. I mean, I've never talked too much about it, but it's like, oh, yeah.
Dry foods would be better.
You know, you could.
Canned food has expiration.
Yeah, that's it.
Right.
Cross correlate two antennas. What it does is it eliminates the primary base frequency and only receives the moving. Because meteors and satellites are so fast,
right.
You get good Doppler.
Right, yeah. Otherwise, you get a phase shift or a frequency shift.
Yeah.
Right?
And at 50 megahertz with a carrier, there's no. It's easy to eliminate the primary frequency. The other thing I was working on is using FM radio stations to do the same thing because they're wider bandwidth. Wider the bandwidth of the transmitted signal, the better range resolution you have.
Right.
The problem with modulated signals is because they're unpredictable, it creates real problems in trying to correlate the signals. So you have to have a supercomputer, basically, to do all the work. And of course, amateur radio people are not interested in high-priced equipment.
Right, yeah, that would be out of their reach.
So with a ham site, you can place beacons, you know, over the horizon.
Right.
And the more you have, the more resolution you get.
Right.
In three dimensions.
Right, because, you can take information from the different signals. Like your eyes.
Right. Now that we have access to these really high-quality software-defined radios, it's possible to use just a few of them to look at multiple signals.
Right.
Because they have good bandwidth. I mean, you stream the data from them using the software, and you get continuous data streams.
Yeah. And 6 meters, there's not a lot of activity on it.
Well, there's a little niche there at 50 megahertz that is strictly for beacons.
Right.
And, apparently you can get a license for it pretty easily because that's what it's for. It's for amateur radio beacons.
Yes, because beacons are still collecting data too.
Well, this is the problem. The Europeans are way ahead of us. The astronomical associations in Europe, they have beacons all over the place, and there aren't any here. The whole country, there are no 50 megahertz beacons. Some people in different parts of the country are operating like 1 watt, you know.
Right.
You need 100 watts.
Right.
With a good antenna.
Yeah. Okay,
and the great thing is that you don't have to have a mast or anything. The antenna sits on the ground and points up.
Right.
So you just put a wire Yagi.
Yeah.
With a PVC pole, so it only needs like 4 elements.
Right, simple.
I mean, it's 6 meters. It's going to be pretty high.
Right.
But for 2 wavelengths, that's 12 meters. It's not very big.
Right. That's
and it's pointing this way. There's nothing way up in the air.
Right.
Know?
Yeah.
So you're directing the energy up.
Right. Yeah. Instead of trying to.
The only problem is, you know, getting the license and supplying it power. So, you know, you need a about 200 watts of AC continuously. And of course, you know, it has to have a little, like every hour it has to give a, you know, a log. This is such and such ARD radio.
Yeah. Yeah, that can be programmed.
Yeah, it's pretty easy to do.
I'm going up there the next meeting. You know,
I just wondered what it meant.
I missed the area.
The trick is that once I get this thing upgraded to this newer software, and I'm waiting for the software I have, the components I have won't work with that software, so I have to change the components now. And if people are interested in making their own, I can get them started. I know all of them, how they work, how to program it. So I can help people with that if they're interested. I've got over 20 minutes.
Thank you.